next topic, that is evaporation. First thing, what is evaporation and how it is different from boiling? Evaporation, as you know, is a surface phenomenon in which we say that water molecules from surface evaporates out. Say if water is kept in any container and water molecules which are present over the surface, when wind comes and take away the water molecules which are present on the surface with it, the process is termed as evaporation. It is surface phenomena. These particles, these water molecules which are leaving the surface needs some energy for leaving the surface, and that energy is taken by the particles from the surface only in the form of heat energy. As particles are taking heat energy, converting it into kinetic energy and moving. So heat energy from surface is lost. That's why evaporation causes cooling. One thing. Another thing, how it is different from boiling. In boiling, we are taking water in container, then we start heating it. When you heat it, water molecules from bulk, from bottom, leaves and comes on the surface. So in boiling is a bulk phenomena in which particles are moving from the bulk. And evaporation can occur at any temperature below boiling point. But boiling occurs at specified temperature, which we term as boiling point. After that, we are having certain factors on which rate of evaporation depends. First factor is surface area. Surface area increases, rate of evaporation increases. That means surface area is directly proportional to rate of evaporation. You can take one example. If you want to make your wet clothes dry, you need to spread the clothes on wires and then only they'll become dry. If you will crumble the clothes in one bucket, they'll not get dry. That means you are increasing the surface area, rate of evaporation is increasing. Another example you can take, if water is spread on the floor and you are wiping it with the help of wiper, that means what you are doing? You are increasing the surface area of water, that's why rate of evaporation increases and your floor get dry faster. Another question which Oftenly we ask is that why it is easy to have tea or hot coffee or hot milk from a saucer rather than a cup. You can take example here that saucer is having broader surface area rather than cup. So surface area increases, rate of evaporation increases and your tea or coffee will become cold fast and you can have it. Second factor is wind speed. That means if wind is having more speed, rate of evaporation increases. Rate of evaporation is directly proportional to wind speed. How you can take example that if there is windy day, your clothes get dry faster rather than on a humid day. Then we have third factor, that is temperature. Temperature increases, rate of evaporation increases. Rate of evaporation is more on a dry day and rate of evaporation is more on a hot day rather than a cold day. Why so? The particles of water which wants to leave the surface, they need some energy. They'll take the energy from the surface only. If temperature is more, more particles will get energy. That means rate of evaporation increases. So rate of evaporation increases with increase in temperature. Fourth factor is humidity. It is inversely proportional to rate of evaporation. If air has more humidity, that that means more moisture is present in air already. There is a rainy day, air is having more moisture in it. That means rate of evaporation will be less, as air is having more water molecules with it. So rate of evaporation will be less with increasing humidity. So a question is, why a desert cooler cools more on a dry sunny day rather than a humid day? The answer is, desert cooler cools on the basis of evaporation. On a dry day, rate of evaporation is more. So we say that on a hot dry day, rate of evaporation is more. That's why desert cooler cools more. Then we take one more example. We say that water kept in earthen pot remains cold. Why so? You have taken water in earthen pot. Water molecules tries to seep out from the surface. The molecules which will come on the surface will come in contact with the air from outside, and air will take some of the water molecules from the surface only. And the water molecules which are leaving the surface need some energy for their motion. That energy is taken from the surface only. That's why surface becomes cold and water kept in earthen pot remains cold. Then we have one more question, that is, you can see that ice is kept in a glass and there is tiny water droplets on the surface of glass. From where water comes? This water molecules which are present on the surface comes from air. Air comes from outside, it strikes with the surface of glass, and moisture which is present in air, when strikes with the cold surface of glass, it compresses there, and the condensed water molecules you can see outside. When you will keep any chilled cold drink or ice or chilled water in a glass, you can see tiny droplets over the surface of glass. We prefer to wear cotton clothes in summers rather than silken clothes or tarragon clothes. Why so? As you can see that cotton clothes are having certain pores in it. So in summer season we sweat more. As more sweating is there, so the sweat should be evaporate, then only you will feel comfortable. That's why then water molecules will evaporate, because these cotton clothes are having pores through it from where air can get in. So air can get in, it can take away this sweat with it and come out. That's why when sweat is evaporating, you feel cold. One more thing, when you come out after taking bath and sitting in front of cooler or sitting in front of fan, you feel cold. Reason behind is, as water molecules which are present over the surface of your body get evaporated, that's why you feel cold.